problems and basics of the networking problems, almost three theorems I just had completed. Okay, first one Thevenin, second one Norton, and third one superposition. Okay, so there was one numerical. Just a minute. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this was the last numerical that I told to try at home. Okay, so I have.
But it's still not visible.
Screen is not visible. So is that for everyone?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Visible, yes, sir. Sir? Okay, very
yes,
good.
Yes, sir. Not visible.
So, not visible. Not visible, sir.
Okay, just a minute. Okay, now is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very, very good. So, have you tried this one? Actually, yesterday I didn't get any time to upload these PPTs. So that may be a problem. Okay, no worry. Just let's see how we can do this problem. Okay, using the Norton's theorem. Okay, so what is the basic concept of Norton's theorem? That we have to omit this load. Okay, we have to omit this load, number one. Omit or remove the load. Okay, number two, short circuit that path. Okay, short circuit the path. What is the third step? Calculate ISC. What is number four? Calculate the R equivalent. Okay, then last is calculate the IL, that means the current that is flowing through the load. Okay, so here omit the RL first. Okay, omit this RL. Now let's see what will happen. Okay, this is your 6 ohm. This is your 3I0. Now pay attention that this 3I0 is one dependable current source, right? Because this I0 is depending on this value. Okay, these two are related. So first draw this circuit omitting the load. Okay, now it has been omitted. Now you are doing this short circuit. Okay, this is your ISC. Now in one previous numerical, I have told you that if across any short circuit path, any resistance is present, then through that resistance, no current will flow. Do you remember this?
Yes,
or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, so sir. Here, this is your, this path, this resistance path. Through this path, no current will flow. So we can also omit this one, right? So let me omit this. Step by step, try to understand. Okay. So this has been omitted. Now can you calculate the ISC? It will be very easy. Okay. So let me admit. Okay. So this is your ISC. Okay, everyone mute your microphone. Noises are coming. Okay, so this one is your I0. Okay, this one is 12 volt. This one is 6 ohm. And this one is 3R0. Now, which process you want to follow to calculate the ISC? Any suggestion?
So nodal analysis.
Very good. Nodal analysis. So which point should I take as node? This point, correct. So I am naming this point as A. Okay. So at node A, what is your incoming current? Your incoming current is this one, already written, right? This current is I0. So I am writing here I0. And which one is your, again, another incoming current? 3I0. Look at this. So this point is your 3I0. Okay, understood? Which one is your outgoing current? Your outgoing current is nothing but ISC. So right here, ISC. Clear? Okay, so this one is your ISC. So what is the ISC value? That one is 4 into I0. Okay, clear? Now, look at this one, the ISC value you have calculated. Now, one problem is here. What problem? That you cannot eliminate this source. If one independent current source is present here, then we can either open circuit, or if any voltage source is present, then we can short circuit that source. But here, this source is one dependent source, so we cannot short circuit this one, right? So now ISC value you have calculated. Now, how can you calculate this R equivalent? This one is tricky one. Okay. See, this one is your R. Okay. This one is your independent source. This one is your voltage. Okay. And this one is your, how can you see the R equivalent from this side? Is it okay to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Okay, let me admit that. Okay, now the main trick to do the problem regarding this dependent source is you have to calculate the VOC. Okay, if you can divide the VOC, if you can calculate the VOC by ISC, this value will give you the R equivalent. Okay, in many book this was not given. So this one is,
sir, another new... were not clear.
Okay, now is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this one is very important. You have to remember this. Okay, that VOC divided by ISC equals to R equivalent, because using this dependent source you cannot calculate R equivalent, because you cannot eliminate this one. Okay, because you cannot eliminate this one. That's why you have to find out a new way. What? You have to calculate VOC. Okay, then VOC divided by ISC will give you the R equivalent. Right. So now here, look, in this part, ISC is 4I0. Clear? ISC equals to 4I0. Now, what is this I0? What is this I0? Can you calculate this? I0 is 12 by 6. So there are two processes I am showing you right now. One is, number one, you can calculate VOC, then find out R equivalent. Okay.
Stop being smart. You are showing foolishness.
Hello, mute yourself, everyone. Okay. So two processes are I am discussing here. Two processes. Okay. In first case, you may find out VOC, then from that VOC by ISC, it will give you R equivalent. From there, you can calculate the IL, okay, from the Norton circuit. In second case, looking at this circuit, this is applicable for everyone. It is general formula, general process. But here in this numerical, the voltage is given, resistance is given, so you can calculate what is the value of I0 just by dividing it, right? So based on the numerical, that's why I am repeatedly telling you that carefully look what numerical circuit is given, what is the circuit diagrams. Based on circuit diagram, everything you can calculate. Okay, so here look, this 12 volt is present, also 6 ohm is present, and since this one is short circuited path and through this no current is flowing, since this one is short circuited path, so this potential is same, also this potential is same. That means this voltage is what? 0 volt, because this one is our reference, right? This one is our reference, so this one is 0 volt. This one is also 0 volt because short circuited path. Again, this one is also 0 volt. So what is your current flow through this path? Let me draw this. This is your 6 ohm resistor. Okay, this one is 12 volt. This one is 0 volt. So how much current will flow? 12 minus 0 by 6, right? So your I0 value is 2 ampere, correct? Now ISC value you already have, that is 4I0. So 4I0 means 8 ampere. Now if you have any query, unmute. Do you have any query regarding this process?
Sir, please repeat this one.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, look, let me erase this one first so that you can understand. Okay. Now, look, here, what is the potential of this point, Y point? That is 0 volt, correct? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is your short circuit path. Short circuit means what? Only current will flow, but there will be no voltage in that path. The voltage value is same. So this point is also 0 volt. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, since this point is again connected with this point and this point, so what is the potential at this point? It's A point. That is also 0 volt, now.
Yes, sir.
So now across this resistor, across this resistor, one side is 12 volt, another side is 0 volt. So how much current will flow through this resistor? Well, resistor value is 6 ohm. That is voltage difference, or you can say the potential difference divided by the resistance. So it will give you the current, that is 2 ampere. Now is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So now calculate the ISC value. Okay, try to join the class before 10:15, okay? Otherwise, I will not allow you. Okay, so ISC value, now you have 8 ampere. Okay, now R equivalent you have to calculate. Do you have that? No. So how you can see? Look, this value, this is your VOC, correct? Just you have to omit the load and you have to calculate the VOC. Okay. Now, what is the VOC value? VOC value you don't know. So we have to find it. Right. This point is 0 volt. Okay. This one is VTH. Okay. So this point also VTH. We are doing simple nodal analysis. Okay. This one potential is also VTH. Right. So now you can use the nodal analysis. Clear. Here the I0 value is already known to you, and I0 value is your incoming current. So incoming current is noted here. Okay. Mute yourself. Okay, now again another incoming current is present at this node, value is 3I0. Okay, this is your 3I0. Clear? Now what is your outgoing current? Outgoing current will pass through this 3 ohm. Right? Clear? Now incoming outgoing concept is okay to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So incoming current I0 and 3I0, and outgoing current is V0 by 3, right? That's why it is written here in minus, because you can write this I0 plus 3I0 equals to VOC by 3, right? Now I0 value you already know. Or not? I0 value you don't know here. So what is the I0 value according to this figure? That is, look, this is your 6 ohm. Okay, this one is your 12 volt, this one is your VTH. So what is your I0? That is 12 minus VTH divided by 6. Is it okay? So this one is written here, right? In case of this I0, right? Because through this 6 ohm, I0 is flowing. Clear? So in place of I0, put this value. Now you can calculate the VOC, that value is 8 volt. Is that okay to everyone? Then I will proceed.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. Very good. So VOC now you have, and I already told you that one new formula that you have to remember that may not be included in some books, that is VOC divided by ISC equals to RTH. Clear? So RTH value is VOC by ISC, that is simply 1 ohm. Now you can draw the Norton's equivalent circuit, right?
Yes.
Now ISC value is here. Okay. This one is your R equivalent, that is written as R internal, right? And this one is your node that you had omitted. in first case, right? Now which rule you have to follow here? The current is here, two resistances are here, so which rule you have to follow? Tell me, I already had discussed.
The current divider rule.
Very good, current divider rule. So, 8, and since, look, here you don't need to do any kind of rule. Why? Because this R equivalent value is also 1 ohm. Just use your own brain. Okay, see, I have 4 ampere current, right? I have 2 equal resistance paths. This one is 1 ohm, this one is 1 ohm. So how this 4 ampere current will divide? It will divide equally, correct? This is 2 ampere, this one is 2 ampere, because the resistances are same. Just take that here. 1 ohm is here, 1 ohm is here. What is your ISC? That is 8 ampere. So it will divide equally in between the two branches. Clear? So current divider rule is okay, and your own method is also okay. Clear? So just look at the circuit. It will help you to get the answer quickly. Okay, don't follow the methods blindly. Look at the circuit, improvise yourself. Clear? So this is your total process. This one, this IEL will flow, and that value is 4 ampere. Okay, now without using any theorem, can you calculate this? How much current will flow through this IL will be what? Don't use any theorem. Just don't use Norton theorem. Don't use superposition. Don't use any kind of theorem. How can you calculate this? Which process you should follow? Give me any suggestion. Okay, do you understand what I am trying to say? Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so just give me one suggestion that which process should I follow? I don't want to use any kind of theorem. Then how can I find out this IL?
So Kirchhoff's law.
Kirchhoff's law, that means nodal analysis or mesh analysis? Because both of these two processes are using Kirchhoff's law. One is KCL, another one is KVL. So which one? Use nodal analysis, na? Because that will simplify your calculation every time. I am repeatedly telling you, use the nodal analysis, because it is the process that contains lesser number of variables. Okay, now look, how can you do that? Using the nodal analysis. Okay, mute yourself. Now I am going to show you how using the nodal analysis you can solve this. Okay, just a minute. Actually, I don't have here blackboard, so it will be a little bit time consuming, this erasing and writing all this stuff. Okay, just wait. Okay, now it's almost clear. Now, using the nodal analysis. So, look, this point is already connected, right? So, this is your zero volt. These points are already connected. So, I am just taking one node here, okay? And this node's voltage is your V, Okay, so this node, the voltage is also V, this node, the voltage is also V. Clear? Now, what will be your incoming current? What is your incoming current? Tell me, what is your incoming current here? Hello, am I audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
sir. So what is your incoming current? Tell me, according to our diagram.
I zero, sir.
I zero. Very good. And?
3I0.
3I0.
Very good. So 3I0 or 3I0. Very good. And is there any other incoming current?
No, sir.
No. Then
no, sir.
What are the outgoing currents?
IL.
Only IL. Because look, across this 3 ohm, through this 3 ohm, another current can flow, na?
Yes, sir.
So, suppose this, what is the voltage at this point? V. Okay. What is the voltage at this point? It is also V. Correct. So, this voltage is V. This voltage is 0. So, how much current will flow? V minus 0 by 3. Very good. Again, you can do this process. V minus 0 by 1. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay. So now you have one equation. 4I0 equals to V by 3 plus V. That means 4V by 3. Right? So V equals to, can I write 3I0? Is that okay to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So V equals to 3I0, one equation you have. And from this diagram, what is the original I0 value? What is the original I0 value? 12 minus V divided by 6. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. So now 3 into I0, that means 12 minus V by 6 equals to V. So 3, 6 will cancel out. That will be 2. Correct? Now calculate the V here. The V value will be what? Tell me, what is the value of V? Yes?
4 volt.
Okay. How this is 10 volt? That is 4 volt. Okay.
Yes, sir. So, yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Now it's okay. You are doing mistake. It's okay to me, but don't use this kind of mistake in exam. Okay. Then you will get a big zero. Fine. So the V value is 4 volt here. Right. Now, what is the value of IL? Because V here is your 4 volt. So what is the IL value? IL equals to V by 1, that means 4 ampere. So how much time it is taking? Very less, right?
Yes, sir.
Obviously, it will take very less time. Because what? Because it is taking only one variable, that is V here. The node voltage you are considering, okay? But yes, we are. Then you have some question in your mind that why are we learning this Norton's theorem, Thevenin's theorem? Because see, this for this process, I am showing you this nodal analysis, okay? But in some cases, this nodal analysis may not be possible, okay? If this one is simple circuit, some parallel branches are present. This one branch is parallel with this one branch, parallel with this one branch. That's why the nodal analysis is easy for this numerical. But it may not be possible for other cases. Okay, just take one example. I am just showing you one circuit. Okay, it was given. This is one. Okay, then if this kind of circuit is given, then nodal analysis will be very difficult, because see how many nodes are present. One node is present here, okay. Second node is present here, okay. Third node is present here. So total three nodes are present. That means total three number of equations will be present in this kind of process. And this is your reference, zero voltage, that is called the reference. So that's why this Norton circuit, Norton's theorem, Thevenin's theorem, all are required. Okay. Concept clear ho sab ke liye?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very yes, sir. Good. So it's 10:40, right? So try to solve one another numerical. Okay, no new topic will be taught today. Only for module one, one simple topic is remaining, that is time series analysis. Okay, time analysis. So just try to solve this numerical. Okay, let me share the screen first. Okay, just a minute. See, you have the book now for your study purpose. Do you have any book for study purpose? Yes,
sir. Scanned PDF.
Yes, scanned PDF is available to you. Okay, so with this study materials I am providing, just try to solve any kind of numerical from that scanned PDF, whatever book you have. Okay, try to solve that. It will help you. And any problem is there, then ask me. Okay. If required, then one problem solving class I will arrange. Okay, you have four classes per week. If you need, another class will be arranged. Okay. Achha. Just a minute. Okay, now is it visible to everyone?
No, sir.
No, sir. No, sir.
Yes, sir. Visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, just visible.
Give some time. Just give some time to internet. Okay. It is not 5G or 8G. Okay. Now wait. Okay. So this is your today's numerical. Okay. That we are going to solve. Okay, now can you see this circuit I am drawing?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So, this one is your 15 volt, 4 ohm. This one is your 2 ohm. Okay. There is one current source that is 6 ampere. Okay. Then 3 ohm is present. This is your 3 ohm, and this one is your 5 ohm. Okay, and this one is your A. B. Okay, clear. Now you have to calculate this current, the I 5 ohm, that means your IL. You have to calculate this one, right? Using the superposition theorem. Using the superposition theorem. Okay, now what is the main idea for superposition theorem? Can anyone tell me? Hello, what is the main concept of superposition theorem? What we have to do? Tell me, anyone? Hello, am I audible to everyone or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then tell me, what is the superposition theorem's main concept?
Sir, first we take any of one source, sir, by
right, that means one source at a time we have to consider, right? Yes, one source at a time, that is the main concept. I am writing this, one source at a time. That is the main concept of superposition theorem. Okay, no need to omit your load. So, how many sources are present here? One and two. See, your basic numerical exam, in that exam, theoretical part will be given very less amount. Maximum will be based on the numerical section. So that's why I am giving much attention on the numerical solving phase. Okay, so try to solve this one. First, I am considering this 15 volt source first. Okay, 15 volt source first. So when 15 volt source is present in the system, what about the other source? Other source means it is one current source. So what will happen for this source? Tell me. Open circuit. Very good. That means through that circuit, no current will flow. Clear? So your circuit will look like this one. Okay, open circuit. This one is your 3, this one is your 5. 3, 5. This one is your A point, this one is your B point. This is 15 volt. This one is 4 ohm. This one is 2 ohm. Okay. So now how can I redraw this circuit? What is our main objective? I have to find out this IL dash. Okay. I have to find out the IL dash, that the current flowing through the 5 ohm. Okay. So I am redrawing the circuit. If you do not understand, tell me. Okay, is that okay to everyone? Check.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Is that okay? So now, can you find out this IL value? Can you find out this IL value? Do the nodal analysis. It will be very simple. 15 minus V. V is the voltage at this point. Okay. So 15 minus V by 4. That is your incoming. Okay. V by 2 is your outgoing, plus V by 8 is your outgoing. Clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So now calculate the V value. Yes, tell me, what is the value of V? In next case, we will consider the 6 ampere source. Okay, then what will happen to the voltage source? It will be short circuited. Correct. So this short circuit, open circuit concept is clear to you. So this is your 4, this is your 2 ohm. This one is the source of 6 ampere. And there is another resistance connected here. The value is 8 ampere. Okay, because 8 ampere means 8 ohm. Sorry, this is not ampere, that is ohm. That means 3 ohm and 5 ohm are in series. Check here, 3 ohm, 5 ohm are in series. That's why 8 ohm. So this circuit you can draw like this also. Okay, just a minute. Okay, what is the value of V? Yes, sir, bolo. Okay, so what is the value of V? Have you calculated?
30 by 7 volt.
Okay, so based on V, you are just creating one MCQ. Okay, tell me at WhatsApp group, because we have very less time left, right? Calculate this V, clear, and then calculate the IL value. What will be the IL value? V by 8. Is that okay to you? Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
V is
here. This one is 0 volt. And same current is flowing through 3 ohm and 5 ohm also. Right. So if 3 ohm and 5 ohm are in series, so whatever current is flowing through 3 ohm, the same current will flow through the 5 ohm. Right. So that's why V by 8 I need to write. Okay. So this is your IL dash when 15 volt is considered. Next, when 2 ohm is present here, in second case, this is your 4. Okay, now this one is your 8. This is your 6 ampere. This one is your 4 ohm. This one is 2 ohm. This one is your 8 ohm. So here you can also do the node analysis, because there is only one node here that is present as V0, or you can do the current divider rule. As you wish. Okay, how can you use the current divider rule? 4 and 2, these two are in parallel. You can do nodal analysis, you can do that, it is easy. But if you want to do the current divider rule, then modify this circuit. 4, 2 are in parallel. That means 4 into 2 divided by 4 plus 2. So 8 by 6. That means 4 by 3. So your final circuit will be 4 by 3 ohm. Here 6 ampere is present. Okay, here 8 ohm is also present. Now you can use your current divider rule. So according to your current divider rule, IL double dash will be IL. What is IL? What is I total? That is 6. So 6 into, I am going to calculate the current through 8 ohm. So the other resistance must be multiplied here, clear, divided by 4 by 3 plus 8. So whatever value you are getting, that is your IL double dash. And look, for every time your current flowing direction is downward, that means from A to B. So what is your total current according to superposition theorem? If you combine both the circuit, that will be IL dash plus IL double dash. That will give you the value of IL. Is the concept clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. Or should I repeat again? Which portion? Just mention. Okay. So that means it is clear to everyone. So now calculate the details. Okay. And send the details values in WhatsApp group. Okay. Clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So your class is officially over now. All of you give your attendances in the chat box. Okay. It will be better. And if you have given, you may leave the meeting. Sir, okay. And if you have any query, you can ask. Yes?
Sir, till when we have to submit the assignment, sir?
Which assignment? Sir. Lab assignment?
Yes, sir.
Oh, actually, when you are talking about assignment now, always mention that whether it is a lab assignment or theoretical assignment, because it will be very confusing, because two types of assignments you have to submit. Okay, one is theoretical assignment, another one is lab assignment. Clear? So for lab assignment, suppose you have done one assignment, you have one experiment in previous class, okay, on this Monday, then you have to submit that lab in coming Monday. Okay, so you have 1 week time to submit that lab copy. In between that time, you any time you can upload that in classroom, no problem. Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Hello, sir.
So everyone, yes.
Sir, yesterday I was present in lab class and I also gave the attendance in the comment box, but you still marked me absent.
Okay, there may be a mistake. What is your roll number?
68.
68. Okay, I will check. Okay, so then I will modify that. Yes, I'm 68 means you are in F3. That's for sure. Okay, okay, so thank you, everyone. Everyone, give your attendance.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, and if given, you may leave the meeting. Thank you.